Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and happy Friday. If you guys are new here, make sure that you subscribe to my channel because every single Friday I do a free pick a card reading on my channel. Today's reading is all about what do we need to purge. So this reading is going to be all about what do we need to let go of and release and take out of our life. So what you're gonna do is go ahead and pick a card pile number 1, 2, 3, or 4, and we're just gonna go ahead and get started on the reading. So for everybody that picked card group number 1, let's go ahead and see what is it that you need to be purging and releasing. Okay, so here goes your reading. First thing you need to be purging out of your life is your low self-esteem. It seems like you don't feel like you deserve the best for yourself, or you don't think that you deserve the best for yourself. And this is because of past conditioning. Like, do you see how this lion has a rope around its leg? So it's stuck and it can't move. It's foggy, like it can't see clearly, and just, you know, it's this beautiful lion amongst a bunch of sheep. Like, it's this beautiful, majestic creature amidst this, like, people of the same, like, everybody else is the same and you're different, but you're tied to, like, everybody else, if that makes sense. And that's where your low self-esteem comes from. That's where this, like, lack of confidence comes from. And maybe even you're very, very hard on yourself. And the universe is really saying that it's time for you to move forward and leave that in the past. Let go of past conditioning. Whatever it is that taught you or made you believe that you don't deserve the best of the best, those things need to be exited and purged and released from your life. You deserve success. You deserve love. You deserve abundance. You know, set an intention to identify and release any remnants of low self-esteem. And then you have the rejuvenating rain card. Clear the past and heal the present. So this is like a cleansing message. So it would be really beneficial for you to probably do a cleansing on yourself. And there's a few ways you can actually do this where you can cleanse your energy. I actually have a video coming up within the next few weeks about 5 ways that you can cleanse your energy. But today I'm going to be telling you, you can use crystals, black obsidian, black onyx. Those are really, really good cleansing crystals. Cleanses your energy and your aura. I do have a few up on my shop maybe. You can also use sage and just burn the sage and let the smoke kind of come on your body. You can burn camphor and then stand in front of the camphor. Let the smoke kind of cleanse your body. You can use Palo Santo. You can even use incense. And if you take a bath, put some rosemary in your bath. That's very cleansing. You can also put mint in your bath. That's very cleansing. Yeah, stuff like that you can do to cleanse yourself, your energy, and your aura. And I feel like it will be very, very beneficial for you. And that's the message for you, is to release these self-doubts and this negative self-talk that you always have, because it's creating a block in your life and it's just tying you down. So if you guys want to go more in depth with me, you guys can book a reading with me on my website, and I'll leave that link down below. But thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you come back next Friday for another reading. For everyone that picked card group number 2, this is your reading. So already I see a huge message that you limit yourself a lot, and it seems like you compromise a lot of yourself and who you are for others. And so the message really for you right now is to surrender this urge you have to set limits for yourself. It's healthy to set boundaries in relationships. Practice expressing your needs, and remember that no is a complete sentence. So it seems like, yeah, people are taking advantage of you, and this is something that you need to, like, really purge out and release from your life, is just allowing people to take advantage of you, either because you feel guilty or obligated or whatever the case is. But this is something that's not serving you at all, and it's kind of making people want to take advantage of you and walk right all over you. So that's the message for you right now, is to stop letting people walk all over you. You need to purge that thought in yourself where you need to be submissive, or you need to obey someone, or you feel obligated to say yes, or you feel so guilty that you say yes to something that you didn't want to do. So yeah, like, speak up, like, really use your voice, use your inner power, and say no when you want to say no, and like, be more firm and be a little bit more aggressive. And if something makes you uncomfortable, speak up. If something is making you sad or angry, it's okay to speak up. You know, you can do it in a kind way and still get your message across, but it's very important to speak up, because this is going to help you cross bridges, get from one side of something to the other. And it seems like right now you may be just like stuck right in the middle of the bridge. And that's why it's time for healing, connecting, mending, and releasing. The fact that you did get the releasing card. So yeah, it's time for you to release a lot of the past bullshit, like, that makes you just allow people to do whatever they want to do, and you find it a hard time saying no. So yeah, if you guys want to go more in depth with me, go ahead and book a reading on my website. I'll leave that linked down below. And make sure that you come back next week for another free pick a card reading. For everybody that picked card group number 3, let's go ahead and do your reading. So this is a very masculine, fiery type of a reading. And let me explain kind of why. Because of the cards that came out, like, you got 2 cards that are showing the lion and 2 cards that is like the feminine aspect taming the lion. So this is very beautiful. Like, I can't, like, this melts my heart. Okay, so the first message is for you to release control. You need to purge out this need for controlling everything. And this means, like, a lot of the time, you know, we try to make sure that this is done, and make sure that that's done, make sure this is done right, make sure that person is taken care of, you know, make sure that everything and everyone else is taken care of before we look to ourselves to see if everything is taken care of with ourselves. So the message here for you is to release that control of trying to do everything yourself, trying to make sure that everybody is taken care of, because it's time for you to kind of go inwards. It's time for you to focus on you, surrender to your journey, like, let everyone else figure their journeys out on their own. You can help as much, I mean, you have helped as much as you could. Now it's time for you to focus in on your journey, because there's like a rebirth gonna happen with you. And, you know, as soon as you release this need to just always make sure that the things are taken care of and the people are taken care of, a rebirth is going to ignite within you, where you're going to tame a lot of this, like, very masculine energy that you have. Like, so every human being has a masculine energy and a feminine energy, whether you're a man or a woman. Sometimes if you're too much in your masculine energy, you're very fiery and feisty, like, protective, very protective, and like a provider type of a mentality. And so it feels like you have been in that for a while, and now it's time for you to tap into your feminine, where you go inward on yourself, you focus on yourself, where you're a little bit more nurturing, a little bit more laid back, kind, gentle, just softer. And it feels like the rebirth is gonna happen, where you're gonna be able to tame that masculine by bringing out your feminine. And your life is calling for you to step into your full power rather than playing it small. So yeah, you're going to realize so much about yourself as soon as you can just let this need go to always protect and provide for everybody else. I hope that this reading helped you and gave you clarity and guidance. Make sure that you come back next week, Friday, for another pick a card reading. And for everybody that picked card group number 4, here is your reading. Okay, so this is a very, very beautiful, very majestic reading. So what the universe is asking you to do is surrender your habit of trying to please people. Speak your needs and be true to yourself. Focus on your own happiness instead of always trying to make everyone else happy. This is something that you have been doing for so long, and it's creating blocks in your life, because when you do that, when you focus so heavily on other people and other things, you're sending out a vibration to the universe saying, hey, like, these things and these people are more important than me. That's why it's very, very important for you to pay attention to yourself and your journey and your spirit, your needs, your wants, your likes, like, everything you enjoy doing. Give it to yourself, because it's very important that you send that message to the universe, because if you practice the law of attraction, you know that the universe will always only give back to you what you give to it. So if we show the universe that everything and everyone else is more important than us by our behaviors and actions, then the universe is going to bring more experiences into our life, you know, with that kind of a story. And if you keep sending signals into the universe saying, I'm important, like I want to take an hour out of my day to get some reading done, and that's it, like I expect it, it has to happen, it's priority, I put myself first. You have to send these signals to the universe so that the universe can bring you back those experiences. The universe will be like, okay, they need more time for themselves. I'm gonna shift a few things here and there to make sure that they get the time to nourish their spirit and mind and make themselves happy. Because when you're happy, you radiate the happiness into the lives of the people you love, and you radiate that happiness into your finances, into your bank account, into your life, your relationships, everything. So that comes to the next card, which is a breaking trail. A breakthrough is at hand. So it seems like a huge reason that you do this is because you feel like you're building up good karma, and it's like you have been putting so much hard work into something or someone or a relationship, and you're about to see the fruits of your labor really, really quick. You're about to see flowering and blooming. Like, you're about to see all of this in your life, but it's very, very important for you to stop doing so much for other people. Right now is the time for you to do so much for yourself so that you can see this breakthrough happen and that you can see all the blossoms and all the abundance coming into your life. I hope that you found this reading helpful and it gave you clarity. If you guys want to book a reading with me, you guys can do so on my website. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys very soon.